Hi, I'm Howard. Welcome to our creativity zone where Anita Hartley created me.
On today's polymer clay journey, going to have a short tutorial on making just a simple leaf form. So first of all, I marbled some clay. Sometimes you might want to marble clay just to give it a little more dimension. Instead of a solid color, I mixed in some translucent mixed clay. So when you bake it, it's I don't know, it just adds a lot more dimension. I use Primo only, and I do use alcohol inks, but I think in this case I definitely used some colored, like wasabi green, and mixed in some cadmium yellow and the green Primo. And I rolled out into a ball, then I made it into a teardrop shape. Some people will use the edges of their hands to roll it together to make it in a teardrop. I can't do that. So I just rolled it into a teardrop shape. And then I take, again, my favorite nail art rolling tools. That's what I call them. They're just small. And yeah, I just made it into a teardrop shape and just kind of flatten it. You can make things as thin as you want, but it might not be as stable. Of course, baking your clay at the temperature for Primo, it's 275 Fahrenheit. And if you bake everything at least 1 hour, thanks to the research of quite a few great polymer clay artists, it gets stronger and stronger. Now, if your oven is not to temperature or too hot, it will scorch it. And that's a whole other thing. Then you could end up with burnt clay. But if everything is to temperature, you will not end up with burnt clay. So, and also before you bake, you could take rubbing alcohol to get off. I see that there's a little fleck in there to wipe off any flecks and clean up your clay. I always use clean hands if you can. I'm often impatient and we'll just kind of give them a bit of a wipe on. I don't know. I'm not super clean. I'll clean them after. Then I shape mine into the shape that I want and use a flat tool and kind of make a veiny idea. You can use a needle tool, anything really. You can leave them plain if you want. It's totally, everything is always personal preference, of course. So you can just sort of press down into, depending how thick, keep in mind how thick your leaf is. Obviously, if you go too far on something, you will weaken the structure, the stability of your polymer clay leaves or petals or whatever you're doing. If you push down too far, clearly you don't want to hit bottom out, as we call it. So I just kind of shape it, mold it, vein it. This is a very simple leaf shape. Obviously, if you study plants, and it's really good to look at actual plants and flowers, and if you're doing something and you want it to look more realistic, well, then you might want, you definitely might want to keep more within the true nature of the shape that goes with whatever flower or plant or botanical that you are doing. This is just a super basic essence of a leaf that can represent a leaf. So, and you can flatten out and use a ball tool to thin out the edges. I personally like flowers and leaves and things like that that have a thinner edging to them. Again, I know it can weaken them, but it gives a more delicate feel, keeping the core strength strong. I was actually recently watching some gum paste flower tutorials and in sugar art, and I have to say I highly recommend checking out gum paste flowers and those kinds of tutorials, because similar rules apply, even though you're talking about drying out those flowers and leaves and stuff until they get hard enough that they don't go in an oven, obviously, like polymer clay does. But the similar rules apply, such as having the center structure of, I just watched one lady do one, I can't remember because I watched a whole pile, on really beautiful peonies and whatnot, and actually in a variety of ways to make them. So whether it's individual petals, whether it's a cookie cutter that has the shape of the peony petals or whatever plant flower you're doing, talking about the center part being thicker just to maintain structure. So thinning out the edges with the ball tool and actually using a foam pad, which a lot of, just like nail art tools, a lot of cake decorating tools are used for polymer clay. So that's something you might want to consider using. and shaping the leaf, giving it a little bit of a bend or a twist or dimension, just so it doesn't, I mean, to me, no leaf just lies flat. And then, again, you can pre-bake them and then just keep them as leaves. You can put holes in them, use them as leaves on their own. You can put them with flowers. Obviously, it's up to you. Some people, I mean, if you're using, I don't scrapbook, but I'm guessing there's some people that do scrapbooking, and they probably would make flat leaves and things like that and glue them onto a page for scrapbooking purposes, for decorating a page or something. But I don't. That's not my thing. But for those of you who do, I'm sure the possibilities are endless, just like the many possibilities of polymer clay. So I hope you're inspired to try making some leaves if you're a beginner, if you're a medium, not as a beginner as I am, but I'm definitely not an expert. And you'll see here, I was doing some flowers where you just kind of make like a very simple ball shape, flattening it out with a ball tool, stacking it, and then I was going to do a bit of a tutorial on that, but sort of shaping the leaves into a bale. So some of them I was taking the leaf form and making a bale, or then making a hole. Here's where I actually thinned out the leaves more and stretched them out. And then I used eye hook screws or eye screws as a bale, or you can use wire or whatever, but that's a whole tutorial for another day. So I hope you're inspired. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. If you want to stay updated and in tune, go to Facebook and look up the Heartfully Creating Facebook page and Facebook group under Heartfully Creating, and join us. And we would love to hear from you and see what you're creating or any kind of questions or thoughts or ideas. And don't forget to comment and like, share, and subscribe if you want to. Happy creating.